Using images and image boards is a usual method in design, and when working with trucks is especially important because we can then capture the essence of what we're trying to achieve. For example, on the F816, the delicate balance between expressing power and refinement could be captured with images like these. Yeah, I mean, an image like this, where it's a very, very high-tech boat, which is obviously extremely powerful, but look at it, it's very refined and very elegant. Same thing with these horses here. They're obviously very, very powerful animals, but still very elegant, the way they move, the way they express themselves. All of this is an inspiration. The biggest challenge of when designing an F816 is we've got to balance the fact that it's used in rather difficult conditions and sometimes not very truck-friendly environments, with the fact that it has to also symbolize a little bit more luxury and the status of the driver. So on one hand you've got this rough and tough condition, on the other side you want to keep it shiny and a little bit, you know, luxurious. So it's a bit of a delicate balance there. The new Volvo FH has to express efficiency. So despite the fact that it's a very big and powerful machine, it has to somehow be light on its feet and express that movement even when it's standing still. So for example, the killer whale here is a very inspiring animal. It's very powerful and it's very intelligent. And somehow, despite its size, it seems to be able to move very gracefully and very quickly. That's obviously a good inspiration. The Volvo FMX is one of our favorites. It's a truck that has to express its robustness, its toughness. But at the same time, we have to remember that the FMX also is used in cities and in the middle of towns during constructions and so on. So it has to be both a tough and rough character and at the same time refined and somewhat approachable. And perhaps this is a good image which describes the personality that we're looking for. Because 007 is a character who looks good in a tuxedo, but at the same time, as in this image here, quite badly beaten up. The FM has to function a very multi-purpose role, and therefore its character sort of has to reflect that. It's a truck that has to look good and efficient out on the highway, as well as sort of approachable, a little bit more down to earth, because it operates in urban areas as well, in the middle of cities. So it's a truck which has different personalities depending on what kind of role it has to operate under. Well, I mean, you can see some of the images here, for example, open roads such as these, and quite contradictory images like this right in the middle of a very busy city. And if you imagine that this truck has to fit into these two different types of environment, you can kind of understand the challenge we had to undertake. I think the result it speaks for itself. I think the FM's got a very strong character which sort of blends in no matter which environment it's functioning in. And at the same time, it's got this very strong connection with the rest of the range, of the truck range. It's easily can be identifiable as a Volvo. So I think in that aspect, the design is quite successful. I mean, trucks, as we all know, is a lifeline of modern society, and it's getting even more and more important every single day. And when you look at the smaller trucks, the ones that operate close to us and our homes, it's easier maybe to appreciate the role of trucks. I mean, they're the ones that bring in the produce that we consume every day and take out the garbage which we then create as a consequence of the consumption. So trucks are the lifeline of modern society, and the FL and FE are the closest ones to which we as common people can interact. So it's very important that they they're the ambassadors, shall we say, for the whole truck community. The FL, when you look at it, it's proportions and its character, it sort of expresses, it's very clearly a Volvo, But at the same time, it's got a little bit more friendly, a little bit cheeky character, which I like. It's a little bit naughty, you can say. But at the same time, I mean, we also have to remember that this is also, despite its sort of toy-like appearance, it is still a quite heavy vehicle. So we don't want people to get too close and comfortable with it. So we've got to decide all, I mean, we've got to balance all these things when we design the truck. So again, on these trucks, I mean, it's mainly the ingress, egress, how it, since these trucks are maneuvered in very tight conditions, you're probably likely to knock the corner. So the way it's designed is to be able to take those knocks. And if at all it needs replacement, it's only the corners that you need to change. You've got to have good lighting, obviously. And now with the daytime running lamps, we've got that requirement and incorporated with the family appearance. So all these are factors that we have to consider. Plus, we have to also consider the fact that there are more and more smaller cars in the middle of cities now. There are electric cars which are quiet, and they shouldn't somehow feel intimidated by these bigger, well, comparatively noisier machines. So we've got to take all these considerations into account. I mean, if you look at the new generation of these trucks, I mean, the biggest thing you would notice is the larger front grills, and they're there for a reason. They're there because the Euro 6 engines, which are a requirement for low emissions, need more air, and therefore the mere fact that the truck has become more efficient has sort of dictated the character of the design. Well, I mean, as part of our constant process of keeping ourselves inspired, of course we go out and meet customers and try to travel with them along the roads that they usually go and see how they use our trucks. So that's part of our process. So when we gather all the inspiration, we're all fired up, we kind of know what we want to get out of this truck. Usually the designers are so skilled that it sort of comes out, you know, that's part of the skill, I guess. Taking it from sketch to finish usually means a lot of compromise in a way, because you've got to then incorporate all the technical requirements, the manufacturing requirements, cost, for example. So it's a balancing act. So once you know what we are striving for, you've got the vision, then trying to get that through all these different filters and achieving something at the other end which still carries that vision, that is a skill that comes through years of practice and experience.